And 15-year-old Jared Kellner was on his way to the opening day of Summerfest when he died. Today, family and friends gathered at the scene of the tragedy to honor his memory.
And 12 News reporter Nick Bohr is there live. Nick, you just spoke with the family.
I did, Kathy. They're still absolutely heartbroken about Jared's death 1 year ago today. The O'Donnell Park structure is about to reopen just a couple of days from now, and I want to show you still some of his friends and family are lingering here. They've been here all afternoon. They've set up a small memorial here at the site. It hardly seems possible for the family and friends of 15-year-old Jared Kellner that a year has passed since he was killed. He was on his way to Summerfest with a friend when a 13-ton slab of decorative concrete fell from the facing of the garage, killing him instantly. Today, they returned to the site wearing purple T-shirts with Jared's picture and privately remembered him. There were tears and a lot of hugs as they shared their memories and their loss. His mother, aunt, cousins, and grandparents shared the space with Jared's friends, even circling a fountain at the art museum where they tossed pennies into the pool. Jared's mom told me today she didn't feel up to an interview on this horrible anniversary. She did struggle through an interview earlier this year at the Capitol as she pleaded for more accountability from construction contractors.
I can tell you that I'll never get to watch my son grow up or graduate or drive a car. All his friends are getting their licenses. We got to drive for 3 weeks before he passed away.
There's a lot of talk here about what Jared missed out on, but mostly it's how much everyone here misses him. Now, a county panel investigation determined the panel that fell on Jared was installed incorrectly, as were others, almost every other one on this parking garage as well. They've since been removed. A $5 million project is nearly complete, and coming up tonight on 12 News at 6, we will talk about the project to reopen the garage on Tuesday. Live downtown, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.